Hello students, I am Krishna Malai, your maths teacher, and today we are going to start our next chapter, that is linear equation. So students, what is linear equation? Before studying this, let's do an exercise. Think of any number, okay, just double it. Now add 10 to that number. Done. Now divide it by 2. Good. Now subtract 5 from it. Now you will remain with the number you have thought, right? So this how this works. So for this we have some magical tricks. No, actually these are the mathematical expressions. So now before studying linear equation, we must know what are algebraic expression. It is the expression involve constant, variable, and some operations like addition, multiplication, etc. So this three things combinedly make an equation. These three things combinedly make an algebraic equation. Well, the variables. What are variables? The variable is an unknown number which could have a numeric value. It is called variable. It can vary. Well, means its value keep on changing and it affects the whole expression. So this is called variable. It can be represented by different letters, for example x, y, z, a, b, c, and all. These all are known as variables. Now what is equation? When an algebraic equation got a sign of equality, it becomes an equation. Or we can say an equation is a condition on a variable. It says that two expressions are equal. Here you can see in this example that 5x plus 7 is equal to under root 2. So this is an equation. Why? Because here we are having x as variable, 5, 7 and root 2 are as constants, and plus as a operation. So here 5 is known as coefficient, x is variable, 7 and root 2 is constant. So this expression, which 5x plus 7 is known as algebraic expression. Now it's as a here, equal sign is here, so it becomes an equation. The terms 5x, 7, root 2, these all in are here. Okay. Now the important points related to the equation. There are certain important points which we must remember while doing this linear equations. One of the expression must have a variable. First thing, we must have a variable. LHS and RHS of the equation must be equal. An equation does not have equality sign, okay? But the equation always have an equality sign. Or we can say that when in an expression there is an equality sign, it becomes an equation. If we interchange the position of the expression from LHS to RHS or vice versa, the equation remains same. Okay, so these are the important points related to the equation. You can see 5x plus 7 is equal to 2. This is an equation. If we vice versa or turn the LHS into RHS and RHS into LHS, that is 2 is equal to 5x plus 7, then this will remain same. So both the equations are same. So how to form equation using the statement? Now we have to learn how to form equations. Whenever there is a certain situations given to us, we have to change them into equation. Let's consider the first one. The sum of 4 times of x and 12 is equal to 35. Okay, so what it says? It said that sum of 4 times of x, that means 4x plus 12 is equal to 35. So this is how we make an equation. Let's take the second example. Half of a number is 3 more than 8. That means half of any number. Here we are taking it as x. So half of x. So when we subtract 8 from this half of x, the result is 3. So 1 by 2x minus 8 is equal to 3 is the equation required for this condition. Now, what is balanced equation? When RHS and LHS both in the equation are equal, then it is said to be an balanced equation, as you can see here. So this is represented by this diagram. Now, if we add some numbers to both the sides, you can see in this, if we are adding same quantity on the both sides of the number, the equation remains same. It doesn't change its value. For example, 12 minus 8 is equal to 3 plus 4. If we add same number to the both sides, suppose we are adding 3 to the both side, then it will remain same. So 12 minus 8 plus 3 is equal to 7. Or we can say 3 plus 1 plus 3 is equal to 7. Here LHS and RHS are equal. If we subtract the same number from both sides of the equation, then also the equation remains same or the balance remains same. Here 12 minus 8 is equal to 3 plus 1, that is 4 is equal to 4. If we subtract from both the sides, suppose if we subtract 3 from both the sides, that means 12 minus 8 minus 3 is equal to 4 minus 3. So here we can see the equation still remains same, that is LHS equal to RHS. The third thing is, if we multiply the same number to the both the sides, then also the equation remains same. Okay, so 12 minus 8 is equal to 3 plus 1. This is the equation, both the sides are equal. If we multiply 3 on the both the side, you can see here, if we multiply 3 on the both sides, then the equation will remain same, that is LHS is equal to RHS. The same with the division also. If we divide any equation, any balanced equation, then with the same number, then also the equation remains same. Here you can see 12 minus 8 is equal to 3 plus 1. If we divide by 2 on both the sides, then it will remain same. Now, solution of an equation. Any value of the variable which satisfies the given equation is known as the solution of that particular equation. There are two methods of solving any equation. First is by addition or subtraction the same numbers on the both the side of the equation, as we have seen above in our examples, that the equation will remain same. Okay, let's understand this with help of this example. Example number 1, x plus 11 is equal to 35. This is an equation. Now we have to solve this equation. What we have to solve, it means that we want to find the value of x such that when we put this value in this equation, the equation remains same, that means balanced. Okay. Now, if we subtract 11 from both the sides, what we have to write? Now, we have to subtract 11 from both the sides. So, x plus 11 minus 11 is equal to 35 minus 11. Here you can see the answer is x is equal to 24. Hence, x is equal to 24 is the value which is satisfying the above equation. So, x is equal to 24 is the solution of this particular example. Similarly, you can see in the next example, that is 25y is equal to 125. So, if we divide this equation, if we divide by 25 on the both the side of the equation, we will get y is equal to 5. So, here we get the solution that y is equal to 5 and y, this value satisfying the equation. The second method is transposing method. In this method, we transpose a number from one side to the another side of the equation so that all the terms and variables come on the one side and the constants come on other side. This is how we get the value of the variable. So, while transporting the numbers and the variable, certain things we must consider, that if we shift a positive number or variable to the left from right, then the sign become opposite. That means if we shift a positive number, then it will become a negative. If we shift a negative number, it will become a positive. And similarly, if we shift a multiplication to the other side, then it will become a division, and if we shift the division part, then it will become a multiplication. Here, let's understand this with the help of this example. X plus 11 is equal to 35. Now, we will transfer 11 to the right side. Okay, so plus 11 will become minus 11. So, X is equal to 35 minus 11, that is 24. So we get the answer, that is x is equal to 24. This is known as the transposing method. Now, from solution to the equation. Now, if we want to go backward, as we solve the equation to get the solution, we can get the equation also if we have the solution. If we are having solution of certain problem, then also we can make the other equation. Any equation has only one solution. If we make an equation from a solution, then there could be many equations, right? If we are having any solution, we could get different equations, okay? We could get many equations. But if we are having an equation, we will get a certain fixed solution, unique solution if we will get. For example, if given that x is equal to 7, this is the solution given to us. Now, we want to make any sort of equation. So, we simply can multiply 3 on the both sides. So, it will become 3x plus is equal to 21. So, it is also an equation. When we solve this equation, we will get x is equal to 7. All we can do, we can first multiply by 3, that means 3x is equal to 21. Now, we can add 8 on the both sides. So, it will become 3x plus 8 is equal to 29. So, this is also another equation. So, this is not the only two possible ways. There could be a thousands of ways to make equation from a solution, and they could be different. Now, application of simple equations to practical solutions. Now, where do these equations are useful in our day-to-day life? These equations are useful in our day-to-day life when we apply them to a certain situations. Suppose if we have statements related to a particular situation, then first we have to convert it in the form of equation, then solve it to get the solution. For example, Radha's mother's age is 5 years more than 3 times Shikha's age. Find Shikha's age if her mother is 44 years old. Now, here a situation is given. What did it say? It says that Radha's mother's age is 5 years more than 3 times Shikha's age. Now, what is that? First, we have to know what is Shikha's age. What we have to calculate? We have to calculate Shikha's age. If her mother is 44 years old. Now, what is given to us? Mother's age is given to us. What is that? 44 years. Now, let's see how to make the equation. Now, we don't know the age of Shikha. So, we will consider or take the age of Shikha. So, let the age, Shikha's age is 5 years. Her mother age will be, according to situation, what would be it? According to the question, it is given that it is 5 years more than the 3 times the age of Shikha. As Shikha's age is Y, so 3 times of Y plus 5 years more. So, 3Y plus 5 is equal to the Radha's mother age, that is 44. Now, here we have made the equation. Now, we have to solve this equation. What will we do? We will use any sort of method, and that is transpose method, or we can use by addition or subtraction equal quantities from both sides. But the transpose method is much more easier. So, we will shift 5